So here are some examples how to apply the quotient rule. Once again, the quotient rule says that if a function k of x is a quotient or ratio of two other functions, then the derivative of this function is, once again, it's never the derivative of these two functions, never the ratio of derivatives of these two functions, but rather it's this, f prime of x times g of x minus f of x times g prime of x, all of that divided by g of x squared. And here are some examples. Find the derivative of this function, we cannot simplify it. Like if it were a product, we would be able to simplify it into a polynomial. This one is not possible to simplify. The only way to calculate derivative is by using this formula. And again, I will, since there is a quotient, you got to use quotient rule. And to use it properly, I recommend to first put parentheses like this. So, and the denominator is this denominator squared. So these parentheses, you can denote them f prime times g minus f times g prime. In this context, f is the numerator and g is the denominator. So f is the numerator, 3x plus 5, g is 2x minus 1. So the derivative of 3x plus 5 is just 3 times g, and g is 2x minus 1, minus f is 3x plus 5, times g prime, and the derivative of the g is just 2. That's it. There is not much to simplify. In fact, you may be required, in the exam, you may be required to simplify the numerator. You will never be required to simplify the denominator. But for the numerator, you can do so. It will end up, you have to distribute the 3 to the 6x minus 3. And then you may have to distribute the 2, and then remember to also distribute the minus. So it will be minus 6x minus 10 divided by 2x minus 1 squared. And then of course 6x and negative 6x will cancel. So you get negative 13 on the numerator. So it's a negative 13 over 2x minus 1.